So what I was doing, go to the developer.facebook.com, go to my apps, create new app, integration 109, create app ID. Submit. That is giving you Facebook login. So I'm going with the setup Facebook login. Web, the URL login.salesforce.com. Okay. Then go to settings. Enable this. Then valid redirect URL. What is the page to which the callback URL should be sent? What is the callback URL of this application? So I gave api5.salesforce.com/apex/. This is a VF page which I have created in the organization. Save the changes. Let us check it out whether the callback URL is working fine or not. Check, it is working fine. Then what I was supposed to do, go to dashboard. When you go to dashboard, once this is done, we are going to dashboard. Again, how do you know the procedure? Documentation. We need to go through the documentation to see what need to be enabled, what need not be enabled. Then I'm going to settings. If I go to settings, what are you getting here? App ID, app secret. This is called a client ID. This is called client secret. Then choose the category, education. Then save the changes. Okay. Then go to the app review. Make it like go to app review, make it live. So this application I created in the Facebook and this application is live now. Now when this application is live, if I want to integrate with this by using a client credential format. Facebook authentication with the client credential. What is the format? OAuth access token, client ID, client secret, brand type equal to client credential. The URL. They give the URL graph.facebook.com. When you give a graph, then OAuth client ID, client secret, brand type equal to client credential. If you make a request to this, we are going to get access token. Once you got the access token, then we'll be able to make a request to get our data. So now what I'm doing, here already I have defined graph.facebook.com OAuth access token, then client ID, client secret, grant type equal to client credential. The same thing what we have taken, right? So go to the Facebook.
client ID, client secret. So we are making a request. So we are going to give endpoint equal to what is the URL we had. So we had endpoint equal to so and so. Endpoint equal to endpoint plus client ID equal to client ID. Ampersand client secret equal to client secret, grant type equal to client credential. This is clear for everyone. This is what is that? This is the URL, client ID, client secret, grant type. What type of method is this? Is it a post method or a get method? This is the post method or a get method? It is a get method. Why? We are passing the credentials on the URL. Request dot set endpoint endpoint. Request dot set method. Right. Then we are going to take care endpoint get method. So take HTTP. Then we are going to get a response. Basic format. Once you know the URL and the format, rest all the things are what? HTTP set method, HTTP body, HTTP header, the same story. Then we are supposed to register this. First, let me take output. Are equal to action equal to then we are trying to display the data. So this is how we created basically client ID, client secret. We are printing the result. What we are supposed to do was
This is all same examples what we have done. But only thing is URLs will change, format of parameters will change. Once you have done the first example, rest all the procedure is the same. Only the URL will be changing and the parameters will be changing. Rest of the story is the same, right? So go back to these. Security controllers, remote site settings. So go back now. We had a client ID. Submit. So what did you receive here? Access. Once we received access token, we can request whatever the resource we want from the Facebook. Once you receive the access token, that means we are connected to the Facebook. We are able to get the connection to the Facebook. If you are able to get the connection to the Facebook, you can request whatever the data you want from the Facebook, looking at the corresponding service URLs. So how do you deserialize it now? System dot. JSON dot create parser, then while this is how we got it. Right, this is how we got it. Once this is done, you want to request any data from the Facebook? If you want to request any data from Facebook, let us see. We'll find out the URL. If you know the URL, we can try to make a request. Now I need to go through the documentation, which I'm not interested in. So I'm not going through the documentation. Straight away, I'm going with some existing code. What was that? Facebook.com/UID. Do not work for you. Make it /4. So let us make a request to this. Once you got this, how do you make a request, boss? Public void. Again, the same story. Now, the most important is how they are expecting us to pass the authorization. Authorization code should be passed, right? So how they are expecting us to pass authorization? Is it a header, barrier, or what is that structure? Yeah.
profile slash get request. These are the list of services. Just looking for the URL, boss. All these are the corresponding links which we have. Out of these, basically, I want to get my basic data. Profile. Graph API slash profile slash profile ID. Okay, let me make it, let me check whether it works or not. Still we are not finding it. Let me try from this end. So user ID. I guess we have done in the last class. Let me check out whether I have the URL in my last class. No. Okay. Let me try from this side. Authorization, they are giving a OAuth or let me check whether they are giving. So this is this issue because the other things I already done it. The other things I already gone through the documentation. I was able to make it. Now I need a URL. So what I should do, I was supposed to read Facebook documentation. I should read the Facebook documentation to find out the URL, the format. So which I don't want to spend the time. So is it Facebook only?
So let us try. If it is not working out, we'll go with OAuth. Right. So what I will use so what was that let me Let me try, otherwise we'll see the other URLs. So connection is established, but only thing is we need to spend some time to read the Facebook documentation to find out the URLs, which I was not doing it. So we got ID equal to somebody's profile we got in boss. So let me get my profile. Right, received search mailer ID, the basic details. Give you the profile data, basic details. Now, if you want to get any other information, now what is that? Your friend list. Now, read the documentation. Make an example. My story is establishing a connection. We have pulled out one data. Now, you want to get the friend list from this. Read the documentation. User ID slash friend list. So, what is the data they want you to pass? Find out. I guess. Come again. I didn't get you. No. Authentication procedure will change. You need extra permission. The Facebook cannot give everybody's data like that. They cannot give data like that. How can they give my data to you? If you're logged in, how can they give my data to you? There will be some other extra procedure available for that. You need to go through that procedure. So for every process, there will be some extra procedures. We have to understand those procedures, get the data. User access token is required to result in this result. So your request is not valid for this. So we need to go through the documentation, see how to get the friend list. What is the parameter I have to pass? What is the extra step of authentication I have to give? I need to read those things and make it. So it's all, the major story is all about documentation. The major story is all about documentation. So how did you authorize yourself? I have authorized myself by using what? Client credentials. How many types of authorizations are there? One is username, password. Second one is code format. Third one is client credential. Client credential. So this procedure is not valid for this. Okay, go through the documentation to check the format, how to get the friend list. Now the point here is, if you are going for a code format, first I was requesting a code, then I am sending a request for access token, then I am bidding. If the access token is going to expire, before it is expiring, I want to request for one more access token. Then again, I will not request for a code, I will not request for an access token. When you request for a code, they are going to send a code and they are going to send a code. When I request for an access token, they will send an access token and refresh token. Two things they are going to send. What they are going to send? Access token and a refresh token. Again, if you want one more access token, you will not go for all this procedure. Straight away send the refresh token, they will send you access token. Are you getting my point? So, when you send a request, they are sending a code to you. When you send a code, they are sending an access token and a refresh token. Next time when you want an access token, send this refresh token, they will send an access token. Only one time. This is only valid for one time. This is valid for one time. So in how many formats we can get the access token? Four formats. What are they? Username, password format, code format, client credentials, and a refresh token. These are the four formats of authorization. These four formats are for what? Authorization procedure only. This is only authorization. But what we are doing? Requesting the resource by using HTTP protocol. But the authorization procedure is OAuth. What type of authorization we have followed? OAuth authorization we have followed. I hope you are good with this example. Okay. Now, till now, whatever the examples we have done, all these examples we have done like a consumer. All these examples we have done like a consumer. All these examples we have done like a consumer. Now what I want to do, I want to be a service provider. If you want to be a service provider, how do you, give me 1 minute, I'll just deactivate my account. Right, okay. Now we want to understand, we want to know how to be a consumer. Till today, all the examples, whatever you have done, all of them are consumer. If you want to be a provider, you want to provide a REST resource, then how will you provide? Till today what we have seen is consumption. Now we want to provide the service. If you want to be a service provider, how will you pass the parameters? Now let us look at the context. Providing a service. REST. If you want to make a REST API service, first thing, we have to use at the rate of REST resource annotation. Now, what is the annotation we have to give? At the rate of REST resource. Now, every class has associated URL. Every class will have one URL. Now, if somebody want to call this class, what is the URL you want to give? If somebody want to call this class, what is the URL with which they have to make a request? Now, every REST API class will have one URL. If you are making a request to that URL, that class will be invoked. Every REST API class will have one URL. If you make a request to that URL, that class will be invoked. If you make a request to that URL, that class will be invoked. Now, let us see. Now you are being a service consumer. Right. How do you make it? At the rate of your So, class has to be what? Global class. Whenever generally we are defining a web service, try to write with the sharing. Why with the sharing? Try to define the class as with the sharing. Why with the sharing class? Why with the sharing class? The reason for writing with sharing is so that the access will be, the request will be performed as per the profile of the user who is running. Don't show entire data. Grant him the data only what he is allowed to. Allow him to perform only the operation what he is allowed to. If I don't write without sharing, if I don't write with the sharing, he will be able to access everything. I don't want this guy to access everything and perform everything. I want him to perform what I want him to. I want him to see what the data I am allowing him to. There is a reason we are giving this with the sharing class. So at the rate of REST resource, URL mapping, URL slash star. Because after the slash, I may give any data, I may pass any parameters also. So I'm giving what? Slash star. Now, everything will have at the rate of HTTP get. If you are making a request to this URL with a get method, this will be called global static I am giving one more method at the rate of HTTP post. Now, what type of method is this? HTTP. Now, when you are trying to perform an operation, it may be success, it may be failure, I am not sure. You are trying to perform a DML. It may be a success or failure, I am not sure. What I am doing? Is this equal to? So I'm trying to make JSON. So I was giving right. Insert ACC. I can put this within the so somebody from outside, they want to insert their data into Salesforce. So, if they pass the name phone industry, I will insert the data. If this insert is successful, js.write.
exception E. What is this exception E? If the insert failed, we'll come to catch. What is the error message? E dot. Now, what was this? If the record was successfully inserted, status will be true. Status is success. This is the ID of the record. Failed, status is failed, error is so and so. Then how do you convert the JS into string? JS dot it is. So what I'm doing, when I want to pass the data, I will pass like a JSON string or XML string. When I am sending a response to you are requesting to create a record. When I am trying to create a record, if it is success, I'll give a success message. Failure, I'll give a failure message. But how I was giving this? Like a JSON I am giving you. I am converting into JSON string. That string I am passing you. You deserialize it and use it. Now, how did we do? When you made a request, they are sending a response in the form of JSON. I deserialized, took a access token. Similarly, when I am sending also, I will send the response in the form of JSON. They will deserialize and use it. This is how I am giving. So what was that? Boss, to this URL, if you make a get request, this method will be called. To this URL, if you make a post request, this method will be called. Now you decide what you want to perform. So to the end user, I will give this URL and I will give the documentation. This is the URL. This is the parameter what you have to pass. This is the URL, method is post, this is the data what you are supposed to pass. According to my documentation, you will understand, make a request to me. Now what should I give? From the Salesforce, I have to give client ID, client secret, username, password. Or else, client ID, client secret, callback URL. Or else, client ID, client secret. Out of this method, whatever I am sharing, using the data, he make a request to me. I will perform the action, give the response back to him. People have followed this? People have followed? Now, how do you test it? Go to workbench. Rest explore. Now, understand what is the URL we have to give. So, if you want to make a request, this is the URL. salesforce.com/services/apex-test. If I want to give the URL, I have to give like this. services/apex-test. What is before services? api5.salesforce.com, because my system is in API5. Because my system is in api5.salesforce.com/services/apex-test. What is the URL I have given here? My example. What is the method? Execute. I'm testing. What is the response they give? Satish? Because the method is? I'm testing here. Post. If it is a post, how should I give? What are the parameters I was expecting? Name, industry,
I am passing the body. Because as a poster, we are passing the parameters. Execute. Response, status, success, ID, code is proven. Right, boss? This is a message what we are getting. Suppose I am not giving execute. Then response, status failed, error, insert failed, first exception on row number 0, required field missing, code 400. Right? So, right, boss? This is how we are going to define REST API service at the rate of HTTP GET. Within a class, how many GET methods can be there? Only one GET, because URL is only one. To that URL, one GET method, one function. One POST method, one function. Right, boss? Are you clear about this? Are you clear? Okay. Now, the major point here is how to pass the parameters in the URL. If those people are passing a parameter in the URL, how do you read it? If it is a POST method, we are taking like a parameter. Very good. But if they are passing a parameter using a URL, how will you take the data? So here, we need to understand few classes. What are the classes? REST request class, REST response class. REST request, REST response. Now, it is a REST API. REST context dot request object. REST request dot, REST context dot request object. REST context dot response object. Whatever the request you are sending, that request is in REST context dot request. Whatever the response I am going to give you, that is in the form of REST context dot response. Now, REST API has two objects: REST context request, REST context response. Whatever the request we received, that is in the REST context dot request. Whatever the response I am going to give you, that is in the REST context dot response. Okay. Now, let us see the classes what we have. We had a class, REST request class. In the REST request class, request class. Now, whatever the data we are getting in the header, it is in the form of, now, map. Generally, in the header, how do you put the elements? How we are putting the data? We are putting the data in the form of key value. So when you are getting the data also, that is in the form of map. In the request, you are putting header elements in the form of key value. Key name, value Satish. Key authorization, value OAuth. So how do you read it? Request dot get request dot get name. Now, in the request, where are the elements? There is an element called header dot get map. In the map, how do you get the value? Get. So, what is the header value? Look at the point. What is the name of the element? Headers. So, how do you get the value from map? Headers dot get of key. Headers dot get of key. Headers dot get of key. Okay. Next. Which method are you using? HTTP method. It will give you which method: delete or get or head or patch or post or put. Then similarly, params. Whatever the parameters you are passing in the URL, whatever the parameters you are passing in the URL, they are in the form of map. So params dot get of key. Then request body, remote address, your IP address. IP address, the URL, the URL, right? So in this class, what we had, we are going to get a params. From the params, we are going to read the data. So look at the format, request object, request dot params dot get off. I hope basic properties you got. Now let me give you. Same program I'm going to give. Context dot. Now, response is not necessary as of now, request is enough, but to tell you that there is an object I am taking. So what was this request? Then what I'm going to take, boss? We need to take the value. String name equal to request dot params dot, params is a map, get off. Request dot params dot the same program what I am doing in the post, if it is coming like a get method by passing the parameters in the URL, how to read this? If it is a post, you are sending a body in the, you are sending a data in the body, so that data in the body will be a parameters for me. The data in the body will be a parameters form. If it is not a post method, if it is a get method, if it is a get method, what will happen? You will be passing the data using URL. The URL you will be passing. If you are passing the data using URL, first I need to read the data from the URL, then I will be putting the same story. Story is the same, but only thing is, how are you reading the data? How are you reading the data is the question mark. If it is a post method, data will be passed as a parameters in the method. If it is a get method, we will be passing the parameters in the URL. So we are supposed to read the parameters from the URL. How do you read the parameters? We had rest request class, rest response class. Rest request class contain object of the request. Rest response contain object of the response. Request will have parameters, request dot params, request dot headers, request dot okay, request dot remote address, request dot requested URI. Now we are doing it. People have got the story. People have followed the story, right? Clear. Now let us test it. Any mistake? I have not changed the method, right? Get method, status, ID, this ID what I received. Rest example. Right, boss? People are good with this example. Now, if you are a provider, it is very easy. Problem is only if you are a consumer. If you are a provider, just a apex class with a method. It is a just apex class with a method. So if you are a provider, it is very easy for you. If you are a consumer only, difficulties will be there because you need to establish a connection. If you are a provider, he has to establish a connection to you. If you are a provider, create a connected app, write a class with a method through him. Your headache, boss, you take. But if you are a consumer, the same thing will be done by you. We need to establish a connection. Are you clear about this? Right? Okay. Let us do one example.